Ian, Asela, thanks so much for joining us in the AWS studio.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Let's jump right in with a few intros. Ian, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, sure. So I'm the Senior Vice President of Asia Pacific, and I've been working with Axiata Group and Dialog for about 12 years now in that role.
And over to you, Asela.
I'm the Group Chief Information Officer of Dialog Axiata, and I think we've been having a very long and I would say mutually beneficial relationship.
Everybody likes a good origin story. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
So with CSG, I think back then it was called Intech, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, a long time ago. Yeah.
So it was about 17 years ago we first ventured into interconnect billing at that time. And I think that relationship has continued today, and we've gone on to much more, I think, a broader scope today.
Let's fast forward today. What does the partnership look like?
Today, it's very much evolved into a much broader wholesale routing and still based on that carrier-to-carrier settlement, but with much bigger ambitions, particularly with Asela leading a move to the cloud. It's very exciting what the future holds, both for Dialog and for our partnership with ourselves and AWS.
Well, we obviously want to hear a little bit more about your journey to the cloud. Tell us about some of the challenges you experienced and how you're able to overcome them.
Yeah, so we started off about 3 or 4 years ago, actually. It was a very small step at first, but now if you look at our cloud ecosystem, we move some of our BSS loads, and then as Ian said, the wholesale and interconnect settlement piece as well. But one of the main challenges, I think, was about scalability, really, because on-prem we were stuck, and we had a lot of issues in terms of meeting those customer demands. So it was really about a challenge of scalability and embracing new technology that the cloud brings to the table.
So how did AWS unlock that scalability for you across your cloud transformation journey?
Yes, I think there was a lot of enablement. I think if I kind of compare some of the other cloud partners, what AWS brought to the table was a lot of help, a lot of hand-holding during those initial periods, which really kind of ignited a flame in the whole developer community. And then with the benefits that we saw that cloud brings to the table, today we have been able to scale quite a bit, actually.
So you mentioned the developer community. It has me curious. When you think about the impact of this move to the cloud, was it purely technical? Was it about cost savings? Or was it also cultural, the impact of the developer community and the seamlessness that was unlocked?
Yeah, absolutely right. I think the cultural transformation was a little bit different and difficult at the beginning. And like I said, that's where AWS really helped us and guided us. But I think that agility, what it brings to the table, because like I said, when you're in a on-prem and when you're kind of stuck, you're limited by that box, right? But here, with more and more demands coming in, you are able to kind of broaden that view. And from a cost point of view, the scaling up and scaling down has also kind of really helped us.
So with Axiata's journey in mind, Ian, let's talk a little bit about CSG's strategy. When working with AWS, how did you approach the collaboration?
Yeah, it's been a really interesting journey. So we've partnered with AWS now for a long time. And as Asela mentioned, we'd inherited a number of legacy on-premise installations with our customers. And we looked to digitize their journeys. And so that one of the businesses that CSG bought, the Intech business that Asela mentioned, it is the wholesale number one provider in the telecoms industry globally. And what we've been working with AWS on is basically moving and digitizing all those platforms around the world to basically come into the public cloud. And as Asela mentions, it not only gives you great time to market and reduces the operational load and the need for CapEx, but it also gives that scalability that Asela mentions. So if you want to grow your business, so now we're talking about adding more modules on, for things like 5G roaming with BCE, enterprise settlements, a bit more that we'll come on to in a minute. But we've really worked with AWS to transform what was a legacy area of telecoms into the cloud. And that's our vision for the whole of CSG, is to be the number one cloud SaaS platform provider. And AWS is absolutely fundamental to our strategy for that.
You mentioned digitization of platforms. I want to go back to some of the challenges you've been seeing across your customers more generally. Does the scalability piece that was mentioned earlier, does that align with what you've been seeing from customers?
Oh, 100%. So as Asela was mentioning, you're limited by the box. If you're committed to an on-prem application, then you know how you can scale that is very difficult because you need more CapEx. You've got to make that decision point. You've got to step up in costs before you get the scale of the subscribers onto it. Whereas with something like you know our public cloud offering with AWS, you can basically horizontally scale seamlessly and match your costs to your revenue, and your business case becomes a lot simpler. And with something like application managed services, where we jointly host and manage that application, you can just horizontally scale. And it enables new features to be dropped on a quarterly basis. It enables you to enter new verticals. It enables you to bring on more customers and manage your costs as you do that.
I've now heard both of you talk about CapEx, so I think we got to dive a little bit deeper into that. Over to you, Asela. When you think about the trade-off between CapEx and OpEx, how did your cloud transformation, specifically in this domain, help you realize your ultimate business case?
Well, I think first is if you look at the traditional model, you have to do this massive kind of overhauling of systems, right? And that causes disruption, not just from a CapEx point of view, but if you look at the business ecosystem, because you're now doing almost like a lift and shift, right? You have one system and you completely uproot it and you put a new system in place. Whereas in this model, like what Ian said, it gives you the opportunity to keep incrementally kind of building these features as you go along. So that itself is kind of a relief because you don't go through this massive chaos, so to speak, when you want to do a big system change. And I think if you look at what we had before, we had this interconnect system, then we had this least cost routing system, and we had a settlement system. So these were three different parts in really one ecosystem. So what CSG really brought to the table was a combined platform which brings all of these three pieces together, and it kind of smoothed the digitization process itself, because from an operational perspective, otherwise the overhead of managing these three systems, all three systems on-prem, and from a business point of view, reconciling across all these systems was really not the best way of doing things. So I think, again, that's why we see a lot of benefits in bringing this to the table.
Yeah, I'd just like to add on the burden of a traditional on-premise upgrade on an operator and selling it for the vendor. Our main cloud application, Ascendant, which is native in AWS, every 90 days, there's a new feature drop. And if you think of that compared to a traditional billing system that an operator might have, it's just a different world. And the thought of you having to plan a major, you know, billing upgrade for your B2C and B2B business versus just quarterly drops coming in seamlessly, it's a game changer.
I could even see the smile on Asela's face when he talked about the relief of that the digitization afforded. Another benefit that I think is probably worth calling out is being able to expand to new domains altogether. Ian, talk to me about that and how your platform helps drive that expansion. And what did you observe from the benefits maybe after?
Yeah, absolutely. So we mentioned a little bit earlier about 5G roaming. So we're already providing with Asela the roaming capability. With 5G coming in, you need BCE roaming. In Sri Lanka, where Dialog's based, there's been some economic issues with tourism, but as it comes back, with 5G, they're gonna need that. Well, we can just drop that in the cloud very seamlessly. Secondly, marketplaces. As the sailor was mentioning, the enterprise space in 5G is critical, particularly in the SMB space. You need a marketplace to cross-sell and settle with all your partners. You know, we can achieve that by dropping a new module into the AWS cloud, right? And again, it's not a huge decision with a huge CapEx burden. It's seamlessly dropping that new capability in. And it just enables business innovation in a way that you never could on-premise.
Well said, and it's that drag and drop feature, low code, no code, that is giving operators the flexibility that they're ultimately looking for. Maybe we talk a little bit more about this, like, marketplace feature, marketplaces and ecosystems. As you think about your strategy for your global customers, why is that so important, and how have you experienced that marketplace manifest itself with your end customers?
Yeah, so in Sri Lanka, we have a API monetization framework in place, very successful, actually. So there's a lot of these, on one side, developer communities who build these applications, and then there are a set of SMEs who basically consume these applications. So the settlement piece for all of this, so you have the application provider on one side, you have the consumer on the other side, and then you have the operator on the other side, right? So all these three have to kind of come together, obviously, for it to work. And settlement is an important piece, right? Because if obviously these guys don't get paid on time, if you don't have transparency of the transactions, then they're not going to like it. So what we are trying to do actually with this platform is take that conversation and see how we can seamlessly do it. Because today, again, the time it takes for us to do it semi-automatically, so to speak, is not the best way of doing it. So this is a fantastic opportunity, and those discussions are happening as we speak to try and to use this platform to make that happen seamlessly, so zero touch. I mean, we use the word very, very loosely these days. So trying to bring zero touch into this whole partner ecosystem.
Yeah, I'd love to emphasize that even more. And there is no way, if you want to drive your enterprise business, which you have to do to get the return on 5G, other than have, as Asela said, an integrated, digitized marketplace that both makes the offers to your customers and then settles with your partners with no human intervention. Because if you think of the thousands of offers in your product catalog that you have to publish into your marketplace, and then, as Asela said, if you're not paying your developers, that you're not even going to have any offers. So, and by the way, think of the potential for billing disputes between thousands of sales to thousands of small businesses and then settlements back to thousands of providers of applications. It's just horrific. So the thought of trying to manage that with any kind of manual intervention, if you don't truly digitize, and that means being in the public cloud, that means low code, no code, that means that true end-to-end workflow with a digital product catalog and open APIs, then yeah, I wouldn't want to try and run a telco marketplace without that.
I'm curious, Asela, you mentioned API monetization. Any best practices for other operators looking to empower API-based monetization? What have been your experiences there?
Yeah, I think initially it's all, again, about how you engage. So it's about how you bring these people in, because sometimes they also don't understand the capability that is out there. So At I think Dialog, what we did probably successfully in those initial informative years, is that there was again a lot of interactions, a lot of small community events that were hosted and where people were educated in terms of those capabilities, and then once you build that critical mass, they themselves feel kind of take it out there. It's like almost viral marketing, right? But again, like AWS helped us at those informative years, for this also you need a little bit of a spark. So you have to, for it to be ignited, you need people to engage. It's about constant engagement to make it work.
Let's zoom out for a second, maybe to you, Ian. Where's the future of the collaboration between AWS, CSG, and Dialog Axiata ultimately going?
Right, so that's it. That's actually a really, really strong question, because so Dialog is part of Axiata Group, which is a much broader group. What we're able to do with Dialog, and Dialog is a very innovative part of Axiata Group, is innovate, experiment, prove out, and then provide to the rest of the group a single settlements engine, so that the capability that Asela is building is very easily capable of giving that scale across the whole of Axiata Group. So imagine a single settlements engine that is able to settle all the operators. Now, they can have their own instance, obviously, or their own tenant, if you like, to do that. So you have segregation of reporting and all the requirements that are needed. But all the operators within Axiata Group could easily, because of the scalability of AWS and CSG's partnership, just roll out that solution and there you go. You've digitized basically six operating companies after Dialog being the thought leader within the group.
Correct.
I want to give you the final word here, Asela. A big theme for us this year is next level. What is the next level of Dialog Axiata?
So I think we are having a lot of internal debate about this whole techco, telco conversation. So we see, I mean, Ian mentioned also about the whole platform ecosystem. So I think we feel that a telco needs to kind of evolve into a place where APIs, platforms, ecosystems, because traditional telco is kind of getting stagnated, right? So if we want to go to that next level, that whole tech core conversation has to kind of maybe amplify a little bit more. And we need to build ecosystems where various partners can come together and, you know, we can facilitate that collaboration to have a win-win model.
Absolutely. This is a great conversation. I had a lot of fun. Thanks for stopping by the AWS studio.
Thanks very much.
Thanks. Thank you so much.